Today we are going to talk about RabbitMQ. So whenever a publisher publishes message to a listener, this can be a microservice, one sending to the other. If the listener is not available, then the message will be lost. So to overcome this situation, we generally go through some other services. And these services are nothing but messaging queues. So messaging service stores the message sent by publisher, and whenever the listener is available, it sends the message to listener. So there are lots of messaging service available, and one of the messaging services is RabbitMQ. RabbitMQ is nothing but a pipeline, or you can see as a queue. It has two layer of classification. The first level is of exchange, and another one is for routing key. So we can track whatever the data inside queue is for which exchange and through which routing key. So tracking becomes easy, and whenever the data is sent to the queue, through a particular exchange or through particular routing key, it is being tracked in the queue, and finally it goes to the listener. So here is the localhost with 15672 is my default port. So when I will go to the queue, this is the queue and this is the exchange. So in queue, I am going to create a queue. So first layer is the queue only. So I am going to add here a queue. Let's name it as my queue. And add this here, add queue. See, my queue is created. And for sending message, I am going to create a exchange. These are the default exchange provided by RabbitMQ. And I am going to create my own exchange. So let's name it as Play Java. And I'll click on add exchange. See, the exchange is created. And this is a queue. In my queue, you can see a binding part is there, where we can bind my exchange to this queue. So I'm going to add my exchange here, and my exchange is nothing but Play Java. So I'll go to the queue, open my queue, and then I'll go to my binding and provide the name of the exchange, that is Play Java, and I'll click on bind. And you can see the binding is done. This is the Play Java, and it has been binded to this queue. And when I will go to this exchange, I can send message to this exchange or through some routing key. First, let's send directly in this exchange only. This is the first layer of classification. So I am sending data in this exchange, that is text data from Play Java channel. And I'll click on publish message. See, the message got published. And when I'll go to the queue and open my queue, you can see one message is there, which has been sent right now. And when I'll scroll down, I can find an option of get message. And when I'll get this message, you can see the message which we have sent, text data from Play Java channel, is there in the queue. So let's create second layer of classification, and for that we are going to create routing key. So that, let's go to this my queue and go to the binding part. This is the binding part, and I will provide one routing key also in my exchange. My exchange was Play Java, and I am providing routing key here. So you can see the unbinding option is there because it has been binded. So this is the routing key which has been binded to this queue through Play Java exchange. And now I am going to provide message in this particular routing key. So the routing key is Play Java, and I am providing message as message through Play Java routing key. And I'll publish this message. See, the message got published. And to track that message, I'm going to my queue. You can see two messages are there. Total number of messages is two. And the second message is through routing key. So when I'll get this message, I'll provide the option as two, because two messages are there. And I'll click on get message. See, two messages came. One was directly from exchange only, and another through routing key Play Java. And this is the routing key Play Java, and message through Play Java routing key. In this way, we can do the two level of classification which is provided in the RabbitMQ, and we can track how many messages are there in which exchange and how many messages are there in which routing key. This is all about RabbitMQ, and we can do the configuration in our code accordingly. Thank you all.